supposed to have a percussionist. Her husband. I keep begging him to come and be our percussionist. So I, my foot has to be with him. Or her fault, his fault, whatever.
But this is something, a more serious piece that Di brought along, suggested that we do, and really, really like it. But this is the first time that we're not using the piano. You notice that my iPad was playing the piano that last one. Was it? No, it wasn't. Yes, it was, because I was playing concertina. Sorry. But on this one, I'm going to play the concertina, but no piano. No piano. Let's see if we can keep it all together. It's called Gauntlet. You probably don't know. Famous Henry Mancini songs, see if you can get it.
Thanks.
I know there's lots of them. one?
Never mind, you'll know it. You'll know
Pink
it.
Pink Panther.
Yeah. Not doing that one. Next
time. She looks a bit like a panther. Don't worry.
Thank you.
Man. When we're having the piano play itself, we need to sort of try it beforehand just to check the levels right and remind us how it goes. So I'm just going to do that now. And by the way, let's see if you can recognise what it is from the accompaniment.
Thank you.
So well done, Charles. Yeah.
But they don't often get to play the tune, do they? They usually just sort of playing it. Okay, this is a song that Charlie definitely said she'd like to sing. A Nana Muscuri song.
Help me call with any.
go back to the real world, he goes back into the dark. I remember as a boy, I was just blown away by that.
Does anyone remember seeing that change of black and white to colour? No?
Never mind.
Okay, this is another dance thing. Oh, no, sorry. This is our moment. We, look, as you can tell, varying abilities amongst this group, right? Some people have only just started, some people have only been playing for years. Some people play a lot when they're very young and then haven't played since she was 17 years of age, but she's now taking it up again in the 90s. Good on so, you know, a guy who's actually really a doctor, but doesn't, I think she probably prefers to play cello than doctor, I don't know. But, and Fiona, Bridget here, I mentioned before briefly that her daughters are really great musicians, and so she's decided why should they have all the fun. So she's really recently taken up the show. So all varying abilities, and you know, it's just not going to sound as good as the Sydney String Quartet or you know Australian Chamber Orchestra would. I acknowledge that, but hopefully it's good enough for you to enjoy it all the same. But we do have one person who actually really knows his way around the violin, and that's Ray. He's been playing all his life, and he's going to get up and show off. you ever been to an Australian bush dance? No? We have. Okay, well, this is the sort of stuff that you would get a bush dance. One, two.
It's understood, it's in the hands of my.
got to understand is that I have a serious memory problem, right? I have no recollection of my childhood at all. Or school days, university. I know I had a childhood, and I seem to remember my father bringing a black Volkswagen home one day. That's about one of the few little memories I got of my childhood. I know I went to university, but I don't remember. I can't picture myself at university. I don't know what, I had to look. When I was seven, I got run over by a car, and my head hit the handlebar of the car and knocked it clean off the door handle. And when they took me down to Manly Hospital, they examined me for brain damage, and obviously this was in the 70s and the 60s. They didn't find anything, so they just treated a broken leg. But maybe a few billion brain cells got damaged. I don't know. Anyway, the fact is that I really have no memory. I know I did things. I spent 4 years in a boarding school, but I don't have any memories of being there. I can't picture myself there. I don't know. Blah, 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 blah. But I did go to university on a teacher scholarship because, back in the 60s, if you couldn't think what to do, you became a teacher. Because I couldn't think else to do, I decided to become a teacher. So I was on a teacher scholarship, and I went to Sydney University, and I was doing music as a subject, and I suppose in the back of my head I thought of becoming a music teacher, but I didn't really want to become a music teacher because I just didn't feel at all confident about it. I didn't know what sonata form is. I still don't know what sonata form is. Anyway. But I did, but apparently in my second year of doing a Bachelor of Arts degree in music, the lecturer asked us to write string quartet, and I wrote a string quartet, and the only reason I know it is because I came across it. Here it is. This is it, handwritten. Of course, this was way before computers, right? This was would have been 19 or so. So this was 1970 or something, and way before we had computers, all handwritten. I wrote a string quartet. I called it Quartet Movement by W.G. Richmond. My name's Richmond, but I put an E on the end. Isn't that a typical smart-ass 19-year-old trying to be clever? W.G. Richmond. Anyway, it would have been played. I don't remember it being played, but it would have been. They would have got some student string quartet to play it. But apparently, the lecturer who sent me the task was really impressed. He said, Wayne, this is really good. You should change from a Bachelor of Arts to a Bachelor of Music next year. Bachelor of Music Composition. And I would have thought at the time, don't be ridiculous, I'm no composer. But this is something I do remember. I don't remember it happening, but I remember that I was really behind in my English assignments. And if I changed to a Bachelor of Music next year, I didn't have to do that. I could just drop English. So I guess that's why I did it. Anyway, I did it. I changed to a Bachelor of Music Composition. The next year, and I remember, I don't remember doing it, but I just know, for composition I had Peter Sculthorpe. Some of you will have heard of Peter Sculthorpe, a very famous Australian composer, and for orchestration, Eric Grace and so on. I have no recollection of that year at all. If I had to do this as part of a BA degree, then surely as a Bachelor of Music Composition, I would have had to do other compositions. I have got no idea, I don't remember, and I just haven't found them. But I do have this original one, my original quartet movement. So earlier this year I thought, hang on, I've got sort of my own little string ensemble here. Why don't I put this into the computer and see if we can make the ensemble can do it. So I fed it into the computer, I sort of played it all in. And once you've done that, the program, I use a program called Sibelius, then I could get Sibelius to play it for me. So I just pressed play and sat back and listened to Sibelius playing my string quartet. And guess what? Bloody good. Well, there's been parts of it. I couldn't believe it. I still can't believe I actually wrote it. I haven't written nothing since that I know of. And I can't imagine myself writing something like this now. But here it is. So you guys, this is the first time this has been played in 50 years. This is Wayne W.G. Richmondi's Quartet Movement. Slightly adapted. I'm going to be playing the piano.
Nancy.
By the way, if you notice, we've got a couple of extra people, right? You've already met Corinne over there playing the recorder and things, but this one here down here, she doesn't play the violin, she plays the guitar, but she does play clarinet and saxophone and guitar and stuff.
She's a member, been a member of Lucy Woven for years, and she's decided to join this ensemble as well, and I'm really glad she has, because she's made a huge difference. So she's going to play the viola part on her clarinet, and of course the cellos are going to play the violin parts. So here we go. Some of it